Every law is illegal.
Every law is illegal.
Every government upon the face of this earth today is illegal.
I remember Bob Marley actually when I was about five, because my dad bought the No Woman, No Cry, was it called? My dad bought the actual record, so we had that old record player, used to play that all the time. I love Bob Marley.
My first memory of Bob Marley is coming home from Chessington World Adventure when I was about nine, and my dad playing it in the car. He got it off my uncle. You know, he had the whole album on, I think it was cassette. I just really liked it. I thought it was really good. Just made me feel good. Made you not happy, or happy, I suppose, yeah.
Bob became a Rastafarian when he was 22 years old, and his influenced his beliefs for the rest of his life.
Edward says, "Thou art the conquering lion of the tribe of Judah. Thou elect of God, the light of this world, Lord of the Trinity, masters of human fate, and the protector of mankind."
In God, Rastafari, and I must prosper at love, Jah. Love be within thy walls, and prosperity within thy policies. For I, brethren, thy companions say, I will now say, love be within thee. Because of the house of the living I, Jah, Rastafari, and I will now seek thy good forever.
Before the plane landed, it was raining still. And seven white doves came out of the clouds before the plane landed. The sun came up, booey! He did his hand like this. And when I look into his hand, Joe, there was the nail print, the mark, that black mark in the center of his hand. So, you know, I said, what? That, you know? And I just turned away my head. And, you know, he went like this and gave a nod, you know, and turned the other side. And so I said, my God, this is the man. And, you know, I was screaming and telling my friends that this is him.
So people still searching for this truth here, which this reggae music, you know, bring Christ to them. And the only purpose it serves is to tell the people about Rastafari.
Thank you. take your stance again. See who fights and run away. It's the fight another day. Hey, put the heathen back. One touch, I put the heathen back. Victory for the
heathen.
Jaja put the heathen back on the wall. Had the heathen back. Jaja put the heathen back on the wall.
There's some Rasta man who would denounce using the fruits of Babylon, so to speak, to build up any kind of organization.
The fruits of Babylon. Babylon don't have no fruits.
I'm from Burundi, Africa, in Central Africa region. In that area, people, they really, really like him and his songs. Singing his songs and dancing, you know, his songs. Wanting to look exactly like him, to show that what you feel in your heart.
We speak of great songwriters like Bob Dylan and various others. I think Marley was right up there with them. Preaching a message of black pride, of love, peace, no war, religion. He was a deeply religious man. And Bob Marley always touched, in my view, on something positive.
I was born in Miami, and but my mother was very young, so she sent me to live with my grandparents in Haiti. And I lived with them in Haiti until I was about 5 years old. And I went moved back to Miami to live with my mum. My mum was a party girl, so there was always, you know, reggae or Haitian or calypso music playing in our house all the time. But when I went out with my friends, when I was about 17, this was the first club I'd ever gone to, and it was a reggae club on South Beach. And I remember when I first heard Bob Marley, I just thought it was unbelievable, the message and the music and the rhythm. And I just wanted to kind of become invisible or kind of be inside the song.